Interesting, the Alfa Romeo SZ and its ragtop sister RZ has been steadily increasing over the last few years, with asking prices for the finest examples now edging into six figures territory. Being coach-built Alfa Romeos built in limited numbers, the SZ and RZ were inevitably bound to be collectible, so it's perhaps difficult to imagine now that hardly anyone wanted this car when they were new. This is the story of the Alfa Romeo SZ, perhaps better known as Il Mostro. Our story begins in the immediate aftermath of Fiat's takeover of Alfa Romeo, which ceased to exist as an independent corporate entity on the 31st of December 1986. During its turbulent last few years as an independent automaker, Alfa Romeo had too often found itself in the news for the wrong reasons. So, in February of 1987, the CEO of Fiat Auto, Vittorio Ghidella, instigated the development of a new two-seat sports coupé to mark the beginning of a new era for Alfa Romeo. Designing a two-seat sports coupé for Alfa Romeo is arguably every designer's wet dream. Still, Walter De Silva and his team at Alfa's Centro Stile weren't left free rein, as the same brief was also given to a Fiat Advanced Design team in Turin that included Roberto Pron, formerly head of design, first at Citroën and then at Renault. The full-scale models of the two competing proposals were presented to Ghidella in July of 1987, and the one developed in Turin ultimately got the nod. Ghidella had demanded a design with a strong emotional impact, and the concept from Opron and Antonio Castellana certainly fulfilled the requirement, albeit perhaps not always in a positive sense. As elegant and subtle as a punch in the face, the blocky, brutal wedge shape of what was then known as the ES30 was shortly after handed over to Zagato to complete its development for production, which was to take place at the Milanese company's workshops. The ES30 prototype broke cover at the 1989 Geneva Motor Show, and the car went on sale as the Alfa Romeo SZ just a few months later. All in all, it had taken less than 2 years to go from the initial sketch to the showroom floor. While the SZ's design very much broke with any established aesthetic convention, the model's remarkably short development time meant that the underpinnings of Alfa's new sports coupé remained resolutely old school. Alfa Corse's engineers drew from their experience with the Alfa 75 Turbo IMSA to prepare the sophisticated transaxle architecture first seen in 1972 with the Alfetta for one last glorious encore before leaving the stage forever. The torsion bars that characterized the Alfa 75 front suspensions were abandoned in favor of compact coaxial coil spring and shock absorber assemblies, also adopted at the rear in place of the separate spring and shock absorber elements used on the production Alfa 75. To better clear curbs and parking ramps, the SZ was equipped with an electro-hydraulic system that lifted the car's ride height by a maximum of 40 mm, actuated via a switch on the center console. Wheels and tires were substantially upgraded compared to the 75 V6, with a staggered setup of 16 inches split rim alloys, 7 inches wide at the front and 8 at the rear. The brakes were derived from the Alfa 75 Turbo Evoluzione, and there was no ABS nor traction control. The result was a car whose handling and road holding characteristics have since led many journalists and owners to wish the SZ had been given more power, as the chassis could easily have handled it. The 3-liter V6 engine used on the SZ is a close relative of the unit used on the late Alfa 75 V60s, known by the nickname Potenziate. Compared to earlier iterations of the Busso V6, the adoption of a more modern Bosch Motronic 4.1 system in place of the older LGtronic simplified the hardware and allowed more precise engine management. The version used on the SZ and RZ had a different injection map and new pistons for a higher compression ratio, resulting in 207 horsepower at 6200 rpm versus 190 at 6000 rpm for the 75. The SZ broke new ground for Alfa Romeo in terms of body construction, with thermoplastic injection molded composite body panels applied to the underlying steel monocoque. However, using composite materials didn't transform the SZ into a featherweight. In fact, the finished car weighed about as much as the Alfa 75 V6 it was based upon, and the SZ's superior top speed was primarily due to its lower drag coefficient. Available exclusively in Rosso Alfa with a tan leather interior, the SZ was manufactured by Zagato in its atelier of Terrazzano di Rho, a short drive from the Alfa Romeo factory in Arese, where all the running gear was produced. The list price in Italy was a whopping 93 million lire, roughly equivalent to 90,000 euros today, and then enough to buy two Alfa 75 V6s or a Porsche 911 Carrera. Yet, despite looks only a mother could love and panel gaps you could walk through, what ultimately doomed the SZ was, for the most part, plain old poor timing. Envisioned amidst a collector car boom, the SZ ended up being launched right on the verge of an economic recession that saw demand for classic and exotic cars collapse, meaning Alfa Romeo soon found itself sitting on unsold stock, despite a production run of just 1,000 cars. The convertible version of the SZ, called RZ for Roadster Zagato, was produced between 1992 and 1993. Although they look almost identical, all body panels were different save for the front wings and boot lid. RZ buyers could choose between three paint colors, black, yellow and red. While yellow and red cars got a black leather interior, black ones came with a rather lovely burgundy interior. However, chopping the roof arguably did nothing for the car's challenging looks, and the RZ's intended production run was never completed. But what's perhaps even sadder is that the cold market reception that the SZ received spooked Fiat's management into cancelling the planned limited production run of 1500 copies of the widely acclaimed 164 Proteo, presented at the 1991 Geneva Motor Show. And if you'd like to learn more about classic Alfa Romeos, feel free to check out one of the videos appearing on your screen right now.